How car dealers are using CPO programs to increase finance revenue. Hi, I'm Kevin Hunter, the Homework Guy, here today with the amazing Elizabeth. Many of you have asked us about CPO programs offered by car dealers. For those of you who didn't know, we're talking about a certified pre-owned vehicle, which carries an additional warranty the dealer put on it in advance. It's kind of like the dealer adding an extended warranty without your permission and then expecting that you'll want to pay it. The car comes with it. That's what the story is.
We have never really been big fans of CPO programs because it gives the car buyer the impression that this is a better used car for them to buy. However, that's not really the case.
If you really want to know why dealers push a CPO car, it's for two reasons. Number one, to boost profits, to make more money in the back end after you get in the finance office. They get you with the pre-sold extended warranty, and then they nail you with a bunch of other products and services and fees. They heap it on at the moment you agree that a CPO is a good way to go.
And number two, they want to get vehicles back into their service department that are not necessarily the vehicles that would fall under the umbrella of their franchise new brands. They are producing another revenue stream, the ongoing maintenance of your car.
Bottom line, it's all about the profits, not necessarily about putting you in a higher quality car. Well, here's how a CPO program works. Once a dealer decides to certify a vehicle, the dealer applies warranty coverages that usually include engine components, transmission, or axle assembly components. Often the CPO coverage includes some elements of roadside assistance and somewhere north of a 150-point vehicle inspection report. This is done to give you that warm, fuzzy feeling that you're getting such a great car.
We touched on the profit difference for CPO cars that are produced by the car dealership. Here's a great example. Fox Auto Group in Texas was recently featured in Automotive News. Their vice president is quoted as saying that their certified vehicles carry an additional front-end profit of $1,500 and an additional back-end profit of $2,000. For any of you slow on the math, that's an additional bill of $3,500 added to your car with no added actual cash value to your vehicle. Probably the most surprising quote was a statement, "It keeps the customers coming back."
So apparently, thousands more dollars into the dealer's pockets keeps the customers coming back.
I don't get it.
Really, people? Now, this is what's funny. You got a CPO car, right? You pay more on the front end and on the back end for having that CPO car. It would seem like you're good to go, but you're not. These CPO car buyers are being sold additional service contract coverage in finance. I guess that applied warranty wasn't worth very much, is what they're telling you. You're getting hit by multiple product offers that you get added to that CPO program you just bought off on.
Another interesting fact is that this type of CPO is not bound by the conditions of the typical automaker CPOs, so dealers don't even have to use the original automaker parts.
That's right.
For those of you who like to work on your vehicles, how often do you have problems with those cheap knockoffs and the actual part that your car needs?
Think about it. I want to wrap up with this. Some of the worst vehicles that we've seen in car repair shops were vehicles that were sold as CPOs. Apparently, there's a little problem with some dealers who flag a car for the CPO program, and then somehow it just falls through the cracks.
Weird.
Take a look at this oil filter. It came right out of a Kia Sedona vehicle that was a CPO car and landed in a repair shop within weeks of the purchase of the vehicle. So why did the customer go to a private garage with the vehicle? Because the dealer wasn't backing up anything, and the customer got stuck fixing a lousy vehicle that had never even had an oil change, yet was still a CPO car.
You might wonder how often this kind of stuff happens. The answer lies in this statement. Car dealers are about making money, not necessarily providing you with a high-quality vehicle. Cars are really nothing more than the mechanism that plugs them into profits. Now, profits aren't an evil thing. Businesses everywhere enjoy profits. However, the car dealership is not a business model that really focuses on great customer service.
If dealers really did care about customer service, or that world-class customer service you hear Andy Elliott talking about, well, all the high-pressure sales tactics would just leave the dealership immediately. Almost no dealer is excited about a customer who wants to have a car inspected. Almost no dealer is happy to hear that a car buyer talked to their own bank or credit union first, which is just a responsible thing to do. And almost no dealer is happy when a customer refuses to pay a bunch of fake fees, which are just profit add-ons. It's kind of like professional wrestling. If they actually told you the truth about their customer service model, if they actually ever let you sit in on one of their sales training classes,
you'd likely never go back.
You'd never come back.
You wouldn't want to. It would make you sick to hear what they teach, and it would make you sick to hear what they say about you in those back hallways.
It's pretty amazing.
Yep.
Yes, so now you know the real reason that car dealers push CPOs, and it's not about putting you in a better car.
It's totally about packing their own bottom line.
If you want to support our efforts on your behalf, you can find the links in the description box down below. Most importantly, share the content with your family and friends and make sure they know what you now know about CPOs. Thanks everyone for joining us on this video. You guys rock. I'm Kevin Hunter, the homework guy, here with the amazing Elizabeth.
We gotta go.